know, we always thought we were going to continue writing standalone thrillers, which is what we had done for 13 books. And really, we came across Frida Kline, or we got visited by Frida Kline almost. And we had an idea for a woman who was a psychotherapist who believed that you couldn't solve the problems of the outside world, but you had to address the problems inside your own head, the kind of the chaos and the mess of the self. So she doesn't want to be a detective, but because of an event that happened in the first book of the series, Blue Monday, she gets dragged into the outside world. And we like that kind of the idea of this conflict between the kind of the world outside and the world inside. And Frida is she's very solitary, she's very self-possessed, she's quite prickly, she's very secretive, she's very good at guarding her own secrets and very good at discovering other people's secrets. And once we had the idea for Frida, we knew she needed more than one book. She wouldn't disclose herself. We wouldn't be able to discover her in just one book. So we needed more. So in actual fact, we've given her 8 books.
We've now been writing together for 20 years, and it's still a it's very strange to us how we've ever been able to manage it. I mean, we began doing it as it was like an experiment, because we were both writers, we were both journalists. We always had this idea: well, could we maybe try and write together one day? So we had just had the idea for our first book, and when we got the idea together, so we thought, well, let's try and write it as one person. And it's a very strange process. And the main thing about us writing together is that we never actually write together. You know, we plan our books together, we talk about the ideas, but when we write, you know, one of us will write a part of, you know, a chapter or a section, and on their own, and then hand it to the other, who is free to change it, rewrite it, add to it, and then they'll carry on writing and hand it back, and we just do that until we've got a book at the end.
Sorry, and I was going to add that, I mean, the important thing about that is that it's not that I'm writing as Nikki Gerard and giving it to Sean, who puts some Sean French into it. It's not a struggle between two voices. We're trying to write into this third voice that we've made between us, the voice of Nikki French. And so we have to trust each other. We have to trust each other that we're not, that there's no kind of ego involved, that we're just trying to be each other's best readers and best editors, because it's a very odd thing to write something and then have someone rewrite it and change it.
Do you know, one of the real things, I mean, what we've always done in the kind of psychological thrillers we write is we really write about what kind of frightens us. And what frightens us, it's not so much there's a terrorist bomb going to go off in 1 hour and you've got to find it. What we're interested in is how the things that happen when things go wrong in ordinary lives. I mean, you know, one of the things an issue that we really agree on is that ordinary life is a very fragile thing, and it just takes a tiny one mistake, or meeting the wrong person, or making the wrong decision, or having one bit of bad luck, and you can suddenly find yourself in a state of terror. And we're really interested in that, about how when ordinary life just takes a twist and becomes terrifying.
Yes, in a sense, we're writing about dread, I think, a kind of sense that people have of feeling unsafe in their own lives. And one of the things that we both feel very strongly is that there's no such thing as an ordinary life, and there's no such thing as a normal person, that everybody is a bit extraordinary, and everybody has lots of kind of strange and turbulent feelings underneath the surface of life. And that's what our thrillers are about. They're about what lies underneath the surface of life. So the fourth novel, which is a Thursday, so that each novel is named after a day of the week, and that's partly because it's about time passing. And in the fourth novel, she has to go back into her own past and revisit something terrible that happened in her own past while trying to help somebody else's present. And it's about kind of almost trying to rescue herself from that past before she can move forward into the future. She goes back to the town in which she grew up and which she fled. And it's about sexual abuse. So it's about this very secret thing that happened, which all her adult life she has kept close and never told anyone about. And now she has to confront it.